Hey guys, this is Nefarious411 and welcome to episode 11 of Regrowth. In the previous few episodes, we've been playing around with the different mariculture, and we were able to create the smeltery and whatever this is called. This is the crucible furnace, and we were able to cook up quite a bit of these seared bricks. So what I ended up doing, that actually used up all of my cobblestone. So I really hope that I don't need cobblestone for anything else. I've just been going down into my basement to mine a little bit. But I went ahead and made this second floor, assuming that down there is my basement, that would be the second floor. And I thought this would be really good because it's not covering the entire area, so it gives me more of a factory type overlook, which is really cool. I like it. And my plan eventually is to make this Tinker's Construct smeltery go all the way up and even out of the roof, and this will be basically a little chimney for my factory here. And this is a working smeltery. It is actually pretty nice. I moved all my Tinker's Construct tables up here, such as my tool forge stencil table, etc. So eventually I'll need to get to that, but in order to create more of the things, for example, if I wanted to create a hammer, I'm gonna need some of these plates, and in order to get those, I would need to actually create these little casts. And right now there's really only two ways to get the casts, and one way would be to use aluminum brass, which that, if I can find it, is aluminum and copper. And I only have copper, I do not have aluminum. The other material that I could use is gold, which is something else that I do not have. So the first thing that I want to do today is continue down, whichever one it is, I think it's two, this line right here, and this is with the infusion stones. I want to get at least 10, because I think 10 might allow me to open up the aluminum at some point, I think. So what I'm going to do is grab the materials to make 10 seeds. And one thing that I did, because this is actually using Essence of 10, in the other quest book you have this repeatable quest, and I've done it twice so far, and it's basically giving it slate, some floral light gray powder, and some weak essence. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. So manual submit of the weak essence, and that worked on that. I have 9 of these, and how many did I need? Did I need 16? Yes. So I need 8 here, and I'll need to go downstairs and grind that. And what else did I need? Slate. And slate can be obtained with flint, which is pretty cool. And that is not going to be enough. That is 13. I need 3 more slate to complete that one. Let's see. Do I have any flint left? I do. So 1, 2, 3. Bam. And that should do it for the slate part. So let me go ahead and, before I do that, let me see the other recipe here. I need some essence seeds, essence of iron. I need the 2 that I already have of the essence of 10. There's my iron. I need 4 of these guys. 1, 2, 3, 4. And an essence seed. I guess I can use my farm out here. And all I've been doing is jumping down into this little pool. I've landed on my feet a couple of times, which does not feel too good. But I haven't died from that yet. There we go. So I have my essence seeds. These are the 10-10-10, but those will grow back no problem. So let me go ahead and place these guys on. And let me go ahead and make my floral powder with the pestle and mortar. There we go. There's the 16 that I needed. Manual submit, claim reward, and now we have the 3 essence of 10. So there's 2 on there. There's the third one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Bam. And I think that's it. So let me grab my wand of the forest. This I'll need to get this bound back to here and right click on it. And I'm going to get the 10 seeds and this will be pretty cool. Let me go ahead and grab one of these living rocks because I'll need to throw that on there. Let's go ahead and throw the rest of it away because we will not need that anymore since having the essence of 10, we'll be able to create basically whatever we want with 10. So that is cool. Yay, 10 seeds. And because we did this with the runic altar, these are going to be 111, unfortunately. So let me go ahead and come over here. And I did this little contraption. I don't know if I mentioned it in the last episode, but basically semi-automation of dealing with the seeds. I can just put the seeds in the chest up there. It'll get in this hopper, push it into the seed analyzer. And as soon as they're analyzed, this hopper will take it out and place the seeds down here. And basically I can just take all of these random seeds, throw them in that chest, and by the end of it I'll have all of the seeds down here, which is very, very convenient because then I don't have to do this one at a time. So let me go ahead and throw that in there and wait a little bit, and eventually I will have my 111. And now let's find a place for this. Probably this. I've been growing flowers on that row. This one's tilled, so let's go ahead and use this row right here. And you, and you. And let's go ahead and check our quest book. As soon as I lay down these cross crops, bam, bam. This will probably have to go all the way across because of the fact that these were only 111 seeds. It might have to go a couple of times, I am not sure. But let's go ahead and look in here, and hopefully I am going to claim weak essence. That did not open up any others. Regular infuser. Maybe I have to do this. Regular infuser. Dye seeds or essence. I have all these. I can do this. All right. Let me go ahead and grab the materials for this. Let me go ahead and get that going. I need four of these. I only got the three. So let me run upstairs real quick, grab all of my materials. I need one dye, one copper, coal, iron. I'll get the tin here in a little bit. And then the four of these guys. There we go. That should do it. I am pretty excited because with the regular infusion stone, I think this might get us the third tier of seeds, which will be pretty cool. So iron, copper, coal, dye seed, and we're still missing the tin over there. Wonder, can I use bone meal? No, I can't. I think I need that magical crop fertilizer. So I think I have one of those in here. And I do. Let me just go ahead and grab all of those. Might have to somehow figure out a way to make this a little bit easier. Ah, there we go. Let me go ahead and grab it. I know that it needs to be mature in order to spread, but kind of need it right now. There we go. Bam! Wand of the forest. Yay! That is actually crafting. That is pretty cool. I wasn't expecting to do that one right now, but I think this one should at least unlock the other quest, and this does look like it's going to use a lot of mana, but I have been throwing blocks of coal on the endo flames. Right now, it's still a manual process. Eventually, I'll need to get that in a more automated fashion. But once I do this, I'm assuming that there'd be stuff on the right-hand side here. Blaze rods. Oh, I get both of those. That's good. So some materials don't seem to react quite as nice as you would hope with a weak essence. Making a new, more potent infusion stone with the essences you've cultivated thus far should allow you further increase in the potency of your essence, allowing more seeds to be developed. And that's exactly what we need. Come on. That is almost done. I see the progress bar. Come on. Yay! We have the regular infusion stone. Nice. So let's go ahead and claim those rewards, and we get regular essence from that. Looking at the recipe for it, it's basically taking four of the weak essence with the regular infusion stone, and that creates this guy. And if you look at the usages, we should be able to convert it back. So that is pretty cool. So let me go ahead and pop you guys back there. Empty the mana spreader, because I'll probably need to keep throwing these blocks of coal on here. Bam, bam. Just to make sure that we don't run out of mana. That didn't use that much, so we are good. And wow, that actually did unlock a lot. And I have skeleton seeds. I am not sure about that one. I mean, I remember making it, but I don't remember why. I think it was because I needed bone meal. But that's cool. I was able to get that. And we need aluminum. Is aluminum in here anywhere? There's gold. Oh, these things again. Those are annoying. Because getting the powders, unless I have those mystical flowers, which I'm still working on. You can see the black and the white over there and the magenta over there. Those will help with gathering all of these floral powders. Yeah, I should be able to do some of these now. Gold might not be a bad one. I think aluminum is this one right here. Is it? No? Maybe it's the bauxite one. I might have to do this one in order to get there. And unfortunately I don't have any limestone because I used it for my my structure here, so I need to figure out which one to do first. I might go with the gold because we do have the ability to get the gold, but this is a repeatable quest and I'm sure that essence of gold, how many do I need? I need 5 to get that, but how do I create this? Ooh, that is crazy. That's a lot of items to create the strong infusion stone. I am not exactly sure. Oh, there we are. Golden seeds. Looks like just one plus some of these Batania things. That actually doesn't look unreachable. But I'll probably do some of that off camera. I don't want to bore you with all of these different seeds. I just wanted you to see me create the regular infusion stone in order to get to the next tier of seeds. And these are pretty much the same way. I think all of these are going to be the runic altar. So if I look at aluminum or aluminium, depending on what part of the world you're on. Let's see. Oh, aluminum. Yeah, all of these are using the runic altar in order to craft. So basically the same way, and I'll do that off camera. But today, let's go ahead and jump back into part 5. I want to start looking at not that kind of coke. So we need to create some coke oven bricks. So basically coal, good way to, it's good for fuel, but building a coke oven will let you refine your coal into a more potent coke. It's slow, but the creosote oil also is helpful. We can use creosote for many different things, such as with Railcraft. So let me go ahead and take a look at the coke oven bricks, and this shouldn't be too bad. And that's one of the reasons why I wanted to grab all of these seared bricks from the crucible furnace over there. This will allow us to go ahead and create the coke oven. So here, we don't have that much sand, unfortunately. So I'm going to have to farm up more sand, because this is a multi-block structure with a 3x3x3, and it's hollow. So that I need the remaining one. So what I'm going to do is probably cut here, because you know what's going to happen now. I have to go over to my little crafting area for sand. Take all of these buckets, right click on this little super crafting frame, and convert that into sand. And this is going to take a little bit, so let me go ahead and run through the stack, maybe stack and a half, and I will be right back. All right, I made the coal that was needed, so let me go ahead and get the recipe for the coke oven bricks and go ahead and plop that guy in. So I have 5 and I need what am I missing? Oh yeah, I need more of these guys. I need 26 of these guys. So let me go ahead and shift click that in again. I have 16. I need 10 more. So let me go ahead and do that. That'll give me the 26 needed. And I was on the wrong chapter. All right, cool. So now detection task. I actually need to create coal coke. All right, so I guess the next thing to do would be to go ahead and place this down somewhere. Since this is a 3x3 structure, I might just go ahead and use this corner. Why not? Might have to put torches in here, otherwise weird mobs will start spawning in those little cracks in the wall. There we go. And this is a multi-block structure, just as a lot of the mods have. And there we go. Nice. And it has a user interface, so you can open that up and see that there is this little tank over here, this gauge. This is for all of the creosote that it's going to hold. You can get it out by putting a bucket in here, or you can just right click on it with a bucket and it'll be able to take the creosote out of here. So what we need to do is put coal in that spot. I got 2 blocks of coal, and that should be enough. And you can see that it goes ahead and starts it up. And I don't think this is a one-to-one mapping. I think there is some loss. I might get a block of coal out of this. I am not sure. I haven't actually tried it with blocks of coal. We'll just have to take a look. This does take a long, long time, unfortunately. 16,200 ticks. I don't know how much that equates to, but this might actually be a one-to-one, so we might actually get both of those back as creosote blocks. Oh, this also makes charcoal. I did not know that. I guess those are one-to-one mapping. I mean, it doesn't say percentage. That's actually good to know. I mean, the side product of it is creosote, so that's probably a good thing to know. Oh, there's a little progress bar right there. You can barely see it. So that is going to take a while, especially to create 16. The 2 blocks in here, assuming that they actually create both of these as coal coke, that'll give us 18, enough to complete this quest. So while we are waiting on that, I don't know. Let's take a look at this one. This is more on the mariculture side. You've seen a few things at the bottom of the ocean might prove useful. It seems that life survived down there somehow, I guess. Blah, blah, blah. I need to be able to breathe under there. So let's go ahead and create the, not scrubber, scuba mask. I believe this is right. No, snorkel. 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 There we go. Sugar cane, glass lens. Well, it looks like a little bit of glass and wood planks. I think I have been putting my wood in the yellow. I need 8. Yep. And this little guy. Let's go ahead and convert those back over. And I might have some glass in here, and I do. So this will make it a little bit easier. Bam, bam. And sugarcane. Do I have any sugarcane in here? And I do. Let's go ahead and convert the reed block back into sugarcane. There we go. And we got our snorkel. Yay. Let's take a look at our quest handbook. And it looks like we need pearl oysters. Alright, so we need to find oysters. Our pearls may be quite useful. Easiest way to collect them is to probably break the block they're sitting on. Alright, so I'm assuming that I just need to put these on. And it looks like I have a snorkel. Let me turn that off. That does not look great. I'll say that right now. It doesn't look great on me. I might have to wait for it to stop raining. So let me go ahead and sleep through the night. Clear up some of this rain. Because what I'm going to do is jump over here. Oh, nice. Now that I have the snorkel, my air bubbles is going down quite a bit slower. So that is actually a good sign. So what I need to do, I guess, is swim around. It's still really dark. See if I can find any of these, what are they called? Pearl oysters. So let's run around here. Might be over there. I don't know if I have to swim all the way down to the bottom. I don't know if I'm going to be able to see them on the side. I haven't really been paying attention for that sort of thing because I've been kind of avoiding the water like the plague. Oh, there's one right there. I don't know if you can see this on YouTube, but I might have to go ahead and grab a shovel because it said the easiest way to do this is to break the block underneath it. There we go. All right, cool. There we go. So that, come out here, pearl oyster, and I can claim that reward, and I get 7 more? Okay. All right, so the way these are done, these actually produce pearls, but you have to put them in water. You have to put these in water. I think it just needs to have one block of water on the top. So let's see if we can find a good spot for that. I might just temporarily put them over here. Is this a smart idea? Probably not. Might as well make use of this wall over here. And so that the water doesn't just go everywhere, I should probably do something like that. Does this have to be on sand? Oops, just throwing my torches everywhere. Let me see, does this have to be on sand? Where'd they go? There they are. No, that's not gonna work. So what if I just grab a bucket of water? Put the bucket of water there so that it flows, and maybe this guy there so that water doesn't run everywhere. Throw one of these oysters down. Okay, there we go. So that actually places once you actually have water running over it, and then you can put a little piece of sand in there. It's really hard to see, but there is a piece of sand in that oyster. I don't think this will work unless it's a direct block of water. So after a while, this will actually turn into pearls. And this is all in the Sea Witch's Guide, I guess. These are all of the different things that we can look at. So what I'm going to do is probably go through this book, see all of the things that are available. Looks like there's also a How to Dive book, and that might be proving useful, especially since it has all of these really cool things for diving suits and boots and stuff like that. I'll be back as soon as I have a little bit more information. Alright, I am back, and I want to do a little bit of experimentation. I am coming up here real quick because I want to create a saw. And a saw is pretty helpful for being able to saw up different types of blocks. Looks like I need some sticks though, so let me go ahead and create those. Ran out of space. There we go. And I have a stone saw, and I should be able to take essentially almost any block, and I am going to use that one right there. And I should be able to cut it. And it creates basically slabs, panels, covers. And then I can cut those into what's called strips. And these are with Forge micro blocks. And this is actually going to be pretty cool because now I should be able to take one of these and block the water without actually having a full slab there. And I am going to place that on the top. There we go. And that should prevent the water coming out. So if I were to put that there, you can see that it just covers this area. And that is exactly what I want. So as you can see, I have two hoppers. This hopper leads into that one, and that hopper leads into that chest. And what I can do, assuming this will work, I can place my pearl oysters. And because of the fact that there's water right there, it's really hard to see, but there is water right above it. That is how I'm able to place those in there. And now I should be able just to plop in some of these pieces of sand, and eventually these will turn into pearls. I don't know exactly how long it'll take, but I did create some extra hoppers, so if this experiment works, I will probably distribute this down the line. Actually, I wonder, that was not what I wanted. Let me see, can I do this? Did that get rid of my water block? That got rid of my water block because the hopper is there. I am not exactly sure how that happened. That was not expected. There we go. You and you. Let's try this again. And hopper. I kind of want to hopper this into the pearl oyster, but that seems to be placing it on the top, and that's not where I want it to go, because that really wrecks everything. Well, that's not going to work. What about from the side? Would I be able to go in from the side and put a hopper here? Or will that just do the same thing? Ooh. Maybe I was just hitting the wrong spot. Let me try to place that again. If I were to place it there? Well, doesn't look like it can place it on the front. I wonder if I can place it on the back. Because my idea, I don't know if this will work, but my idea would be to pop in some sand here, and this should automatically feed. So once the, I really don't need too many of these pearl oysters then. All I would have to do is feed it in like that, and after a while, they will eventually have a bunch of pearls in here. So that is pretty swell. Nice. And what we can do with the pearl oysters, we're going to get into all of this at a later date. I don't think I have enough time in this episode. So let me take a look at the Sea Witch's Guide, because this is going to allow us to do different types of enchantments, which is really cool, because basically the pearl oysters, the pearls, you can create different pieces of jewelry, as you can see here. And we'll be able to enchant those jewelry with all of these special Mariculture enchants like Sonic the Hedgehog, increase your speed while sprinting, leapfrog, jump one extra block per level. Oh, that's kind of cool. I think there's one called Spider-Man. There's Superman. Power of Flight. Level increases the speed. Use the enchant key while airborne to change speed. Oh. That might actually give us flight earlier than not. So that is pretty cool. We will have to see what we can do once we actually get a few of these pearls taken care of. So, I guess I do have a blue pearl. I don't know what blue can do. Blue. Immune to drowning damage. This enchantment entirely unique. That's actually an enchantment, though. I don't know if these do anything special. Yeah, I'm going to have to look at this a little bit further, because there's probably a difference between the rings versus the three pearl, whatever that is, and the full pearl necklace. Based upon like durability. Oh, there's a ring, iron and gold bracelet. Well, yeah, I don't know. It's something that we can experiment with later, but I am just going to let that run. I put a good 26 sand in here. So over a period of time, this will eventually have all of the pearls that I need. Might as well just go ahead and keep all of this stuff down here. That way I don't have to deal with it. Let me go ahead and throw my snorkel in there as well. We should be good. All right, cool. So, I don't know how I'm on time, so let me check and I'll be back. All right, it does look like I have reached that wrapping up point. We were able to start a little bit more on the Mariculture. As I said before, I will go ahead and wait for the coal coke to complete, because there's nothing that we can do until that is done. So let me go ahead and check that while I still have you. Yeah, it is actually almost done. And it's produced quite a bit of creosote oil. Well, you can probably wait a little bit for that. I don't really know what I'm going to do next. I do want to continue with some of this mariculture stuff, because that seems to be a good way to get some of these next level enchants. Let's see. I would like to go down more on the Batania side, because we need to start doing these different runes, because I did look at the gold and stuff like that. I actually forgot. Oh, I always forget which one these are in. There we go. In order to create gold seeds, I need the runes. And that is probably what we'll start out with the next episode, so that we can get some of these next tier. And there we go. Two blocks of coal coke. And that should do it for that particular one. And it does look like it. Yay! And that did not open up any new quest lines. Ugh. All right. But I do want to go ahead and continue throwing coal in here. I mean, why not? Because this does burn a little bit better, more efficiently than normal coal. So I might as well just go ahead and do it. But I am going to wrap up here. I really hope that you enjoyed the episode. If you could, rate and comment down below. It would be greatly appreciated. And also, if you like the series, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. But for now, this is goodbye.